Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. When reading Bitcoin news, we occasionally come across new terms. One such term is Bitcoin tumbler or mixer. What are mixers? What is their purpose? And are they legal? These are questions this episode of Blockchain Central will answer. So, from the news and stories, you might think Bitcoin is anonymous. In fact, it can be. But for a lot of us, it most likely isn't. To explain this, let's have a more detailed look at how money is sent. Users have addresses, and this is what they could look like. Each address has a balance. This balance consists of a sum of all transactions, but each transaction is stored on a public ledger. This means every single move of Bitcoin can be seen by everyone. This is what we call pseudonymity. It means that you are not really anonymous, as your transactions are publicly connected to one address. We have a special video for this, if you're interested in the difference. But from a privacy standpoint, that can be problematic, especially for criminals. Let's say you want to keep your transactions private. For starters, you need to take care of the address. It should not be connected to you as a person. Say someone sees a payment going from address A to address B. Well, great, there's nothing they can do, as nobody knows that Alice is owning address A. Once there is a connection between Alice and address A, the protection is gone. This happens when you sign up for an exchange. Usually they require you to provide KYC documents. KYC stands for Know Your Customer, and it's enforced by law. As a result, your passport is now connected to your Bitcoin address. The second level of protection works on the transaction itself. When A sends money to B, it is observable. The idea behind a Bitcoin mixer is that lots of people send money to it. In the mixer, these funds arrive and mix. Then, the mixer pays the target addresses. That way, nobody knows whose money arrived at which address. So even if you know that Alice owns A, you have no idea if she paid money to E or D. On a technical level, there are a few different ways to implement this. The core feature, obviously, is anonymity. That is why it is necessary to make sure the service is not compromised and analyzed. To gain trust, a lot of mixers choose an open source structure. That way you can ensure users that you are not going to steal their money. Those mixers are then also free. The only thing you would need to pay is the transaction fee. In the mixer model, transaction fees occur twice, sending to the mixer and from there to the target address. To increase this protection, you can connect mixers. So, your money goes from one mixer to the next and will eventually reach the recipient. Another aspect is the amount. Say Bob sends 3.432 Bitcoin into the mixer, then Claire receives 3.432 Bitcoin. It is easy to infer that these payments are connected. For further obfuscation, time and amount both need to be hidden, so payments can be intentionally split up into smaller ones. They can also be delayed to hide the timestamp. Here is an interesting thought. The Bitcoin ledger is public. In the years to come, authorities might find out who owned some addresses. With that, they could trace back transactions. Say a drug dealer gets caught and their address confiscated. Authorities can then easily see who was sending Bitcoins to this address. If a mixer was used, this becomes far more difficult. A word of caution. Bitcoin mixers are technically interesting. They bring privacy and anonymity. However, they also help criminals hide from authorities. Apart from Bitcoin mixers, one could use different currencies. Projects like Dash or Zcash have such mixer functionalities built in. Monero has similar features built in. We have extra videos on these if you're curious. Okay, what have we learned today? If you want to hide your Bitcoin payments, you need mixers. This applies to rebels and political organizations in oppressed countries. It also holds true for drug dealers and contract killers. The technical ramifications of Bitcoin mixers are interesting regardless. And that is also why we made this video. Before you go, please note that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing.